Hi, I'm Srinivasan from Sri Sai Sadbhavana School. We have finished the first lesson in science, that is adaptation. First lesson as well as second lesson also we have finished. In the second lesson, we have studied about the adaptation in plants. In the third lesson, we have studied about the adaptation in animals. I explained in the first lesson, adaptation. That means to the surroundings we have to adapt ourselves. To live on the earth. Otherwise, what will happen? We can't live. It is not possible to live on the earth. Okay. So to the surroundings where we are living, so we have to adapt ourselves. For the survival purpose. So that is called as adaptation. Now, in the last chapter, we have studied how the plants, they have adapted themselves for their survival. Okay. Here in this lesson, we'll study about the animals, how they have adapted, how their body has modified for the living purpose on the earth, or to survive on the earth, or to continue their generation on the earth. Okay. Here the third lesson on adaptation in animals. I will read the lesson. Thousands of years ago, huge animals like dinosaur and lizard lived on the earth. Now they do not exist. They have become extinct on the earth. These animals could not adapt themselves according to their changing environments. An animal should be able to protect itself and find food in order to live in its environment. When an animal is able to do so successfully, it is said to have adapted to its environment. All animals are adapted to live at a certain place. The place where an animal lives is called its habitat. A habitat can be on land, in water, in air, or on trees. That means, now we are seeing in the films that more than thousand years ago, huge animals like, huge means big. What is the meaning of huge? Large or big animals lives on the earth by name dinosaurs. And huge lizards. These are living on the earth. Okay. Now they have present? No, they do not exist. That means now they are not present. Why? They have become extinct on the earth. Their life has come to an end. Okay, their generation come to an end. Why? These animals could not adapt themselves according to their changing environment. Because the environment is changing day by day. So they are not ready to adapt. Okay, they have not started adaptation. So their life come to an extinct. That is, now they are not there. They do not exist now. They do not exist now because they have not adapted themselves to the environment. Okay, an animal should be able to protect itself. That means according to the weather condition, according to the climate, it has to protect itself and find food also. Find food. That means to survive, to live, they need the food also. And to exist on the earth, they have to find the ways to find the food also. To live in its environment. When an animal is able to do so successfully, that means it will adjust to the environment as well as it, if it finds its food, so it can exist on the earth. That means their adaptation, they have adapted to the environment. That says that they have adapted to the environment. That means protect themselves from the environment or environmental changes. And if they find the food, that means their adaptation is completed. When an animal is able to do so successfully, it is said to have adapted to its environment. That means an animal should be able to protect itself, and if it finds the food for itself, so it is adapted to that environment. It is adapted to its environment. All animals are adapted to live at a certain place. The place where an animal lives is called its habitat. They have adjusted to some areas. That means some landforms. So that area is called as its habitat. Its habitat. That means the area where it lives is called its habitat. That means we are living in some area, that is our habitat. That is our habitat. Okay. The place where animal live is called its habitat. A habitat can be on land. Maybe on land, in water, or in air, or on trees. That means on the earth, they live only in these places. That means on the land, or in water, or in air, or on trees. Okay. These are the four habitats located on the earth. Okay. Mainly, that is on land, or in water, or in air, or on trees. Okay. Now, adaptation to environment. We will go next. Adaptation to environment. Terrestrial or land animals. That means on the land, how they find the habitat and how they have adapted to themselves on the land they have given. Terrestrial or land animals. Animals that live on land are called terrestrial animals. They have well-developed sense organs and nervous system to adapt to their environment. They can be categorized into desert animals, polar animals, and grassland animals. That means terrestrial or land animals. I already told that the habitat can be divided into land, water, air, and trees. Now we'll go the animals or the habitat or the adaptation, how the animals are living on the land. How the animals are living on the land. That is called as terrestrial land or land animals. We call them as terrestrial or land animals. That means animals which are living on the earth. They are called as terrestrial animals or land animals. They have well-developed sense organs. That means they have well-developed sense organs. You know very well, sense organs are skin, tongue, nose, ears, eyes. Five sense organs, they have very developed, and nervous systems to adapt their environment. That means they have the developed nervous system also. They can be categorized into, once again, here they are divided into desert animals, polar animals, and grassland animals. Desert animals, polar animals, and grassland animals. So when you come to the animals which are living on the land, that is terrestrial or land animals, it is divided into three categories. Desert animals, polar animals, and grassland animals. First, we'll go with the desert animals. You know very well what are the weather conditions in the desert. What are the weather conditions in the desert? That means so much of hot, lack of water. So these are the weather conditions, and also no greenery at all. Okay, these are the weather conditions of the desert. Okay, now I will read. The lack of water and extreme temperatures are the two main features of deserts these animals must adapt to. Many desert animals avoid heat by simply staying out of it as much as possible. Since water is very scarce, most desert animals get their water from the food they eat. Animals like kangaroo, rat and lizard live in burrows. They stay inside during the day and emerge at night to feed themselves. The kidneys of desert animals concentrate urine so that they excrete less water. A camel can travel for a week or more without drinking water and can last for several months without eating food. Camel's feet are wide so they can walk on sand more easily. Here they are given the desert animals, how they have adapted themselves. Here I have already explained the lack of water and extreme temperature are two main features of the deserts. That means lack of water. No water, that means very little water is present in the desert area and high temperature. And high temperature. These are the two physical features. That means these are the very, very important features of the desert. Okay. For this, they have to adapt themselves. These desert animals adapt to these two features. Okay. Many desert animals avoid heat by simply staying out of it as much as possible. That means they won't wander in the daytime, because in the daytime they're so much of hot. So to avoid that, they won't travel or they won't let out in the day. They stay in some shady places or hide in some shady places. Okay, as much as possible. Since water is very scarce, that means lack of water, they eat, they get the water from the food what they eat. They get the water from the food what they get. Okay. Most desert animals get their water from the food they eat. Animals like kangaroo, which are the animals they live? Kangaroo, rat and lizard. They live in burrows. That means hiding in the burrows, shady places. Okay. They stay inside during the day and emerge at night to feed themselves. And in the day, they sleep or they stay in shady places, and in the night they let out for themselves to feed themselves. That means in search of food. In search of food, they come out in the night only. Okay. The kidneys of desert animals concentrate urine. That means they won't give out urine. Okay. They filter the water particles. Okay. And so that they excrete less water. They excrete very, very less water. Excrete means throwing out. Okay. A camel can travel for a week. See, camel is called as the sheep of the desert. A camel can travel for a week or more without drinking water and can last for several months without eating food. That means a camel can stay or travel for a week or more without drinking a single drop of water. Okay, and can last for several months without eating food, and it can live without food for several months. Okay, camel's feet are wide, and so that walk on sand more easily. Its feet is more wide to walk on the sand easily. So these are how the desert animals adapt themselves to the desert conditions. If you want to live, you have to adapt yourself to that conditions only. Otherwise, you will get extinct. That means you will die. So they adapted themselves for the lack of water. So the camel cannot drink for a week. It can't drink even a single drop. Okay, if it is available, it will drink plenty of water and stores in some places. Okay, in the body, high temperature. So the animals, they don't let in the daytime, they come out in the night time for the purpose of searching the food. Okay, now we understand what are the desert animals and which are the desert animals and how they are adapted to the desert conditions. Okay, next we'll come to polar animals. polar animals. Here extreme heat, here extreme cold. In polar regions, dead opposite to the desert. Opposite to the desert. I am reading, the areas around the northern and southern poles of the earth are very cold regions. These places are called polar areas. The polar areas are covered by snow and ice is the most part of the year. And ice in most part of the year. The white fur of a polar bear helps it to blend in with snow and ice. They have a layer of fat under their skin and fur that helps them stay warm. The wide and large paws help a polar bear walk in the snow. Penguins have webbed feet for doing powerful swimming. They have thick skin and lots of fat under their skin to keep themselves warm in cold weather. Their tightly packed feathers overlap to provide waterproofing and warmth. Muskox, seal and walrus are some other animals that have adapted themselves to these regions to survive. As I have told, this polar region is very, very extreme cold. That means we can't imagine here now. Okay, it is very much cold. The areas around the northern and southern poles of the earth are very cold regions. That means extreme points. When you consider the earth, okay, this north pole and south pole are very, very cold. Very cold regions. These places are called polar areas. What we call it as polar areas. We call them as polar areas. The polar areas are covered by snow and ice in most part of the year. That means in most throughout the year, they cover with the ice. They cover with the ice. Okay. Then how the animals are adapted in these areas? How the animals are adapted or how they will live? Here there is no water, here plenty of water with ice. Plenty of water with ice. Here the white fur of a polar bear helps to blend in with snow and ice. Blend means mix up. That means to stay there. The white fur. Fur means what you are wearing, the sweaters. You are wearing the sweaters. Like that the God has given the structure itself, the fur. Okay. They have a layer of fat under their skin. That means if the skin is there, they have a thick layer of fat. Thick layer of fat. Okay, which under their skin and fur that helps them stay warm. That fur which is present on the bear, polar bears, helps them to stay warm. Stay warm. That means it is like in cold, what we do, we will wear the sweaters for warm purpose to heat our body, ourselves, so that they have their own fur that keeps them to stay warm. Okay, the wide and large paws helps the polar bear walk in the snow. Here also, they have got wide and large paws. Paws means this area of the legs. Okay, this area of the legs, okay. They have thick skin and lots of fat under their skin to keep themselves warm in cold water. Sorry, I have jumped one line. Okay, penguins have webbed feet for doing powerful swimming. Next comes to penguin. Here first about the polar bears we have discussed. Next come to penguins. Here the animals which are living are polar bears and the penguins. So next, penguins have webbed feet for doing powerful swimming. They have the webbed feet for doing the powerful swimming that in the glaciers. Okay, they have thick skin and lots of fat under their skin to keep themselves warm in cold weather. They also have the thick fat which keeps them hot in the body. Okay, their tightly packed feathers, that means their feathers are very tightly packed like the coat. Tightly packed like the could, okay, to provide waterproofing and warmth. That means waterproof as well as warm. Warm means heat. Okay, to keep them heat. Here, which are the animals living is musk ox, seal, and walrus are some other animals that have adapted themselves to these regions to survive. Okay, how these polar animals, they have a fat below the skin, which helps them to keep warm. Okay, and they have fur-like structure to protect themselves from the cold. That means here they are adapted to the cold condition. Here in desert, they are adapted to the hot conditions. I hope now you are understanding. Okay. Next, we'll come to grassland animals. I will read the sheep, horse, giraffe, zebra, kangaroo, and rhinoceros are some animals that have adapted themselves to the climates of a grassland to survive. Long necks of giraffes allow them to eat leaves of treetops and spot predators. Long and tough tongues enable them to pull leaves from branches without getting hurt by the thorns during the feeding process. Animals like snakes do not have legs. They have scales that help them to crawl. Animals like lizards and frogs sleep for several months to protect themselves from cold. This is called hibernation. Okay, now we are coming to grassland animals. Here they are given the names, some of the animals which are living in the grassland, that is sheep, horse, giraffe, zebra, kangaroo, rhinoceros are the examples for grassland animals. How they have adapted themselves to grassland and they have survived. Okay, long necks of giraffe. Long necks of giraffe is very much useful for to allow them to eat leaves of treetops. If the food is not available on the land, it will pluck it from the trees. And spot predators. Predator means enemies. To spot the enemies. If you have long neck, we will see where the enemies are coming. Like that, it will do the same. Okay, predators means enemies. Okay, to spot predators means to look at the enemies who is coming. Okay, by this long neck, it is easy to feed on the leaves or the feed on the branches. Okay, long and tough tongue. It has long and tough tongue. Enable them to pull leaves from the branches without getting hurt by the thorns during the feeding process. Okay, some leaves have sharp thorns. Okay, that tongue is very, very tough. The giraffe's tongue is very, very tough. If a thorn will pierce also, it can't hurt. Okay, it will eat these thorns also. Long and tough tongue enables them to pull leaves from branches without getting hurt by the thorns during the feeding processes. Next, animals like snakes. Not only these animals, snakes also live on the grassland. They do not have legs. Snakes don't have legs. They have scales that help them to crawl. They have the scales. If the body of the snake is like this, they have this scales-like structure. I hope you have seen. Okay, the scales-like structure, it will help them to crawl. Animals like lizards and frogs sleep for several months. The animals like lizards and frogs sleeps for several months to protect themselves from cold. When in the cold condition, okay, they can't live, then they will hide in some places and they will take rest for several months. That means they will sleep. for several months without food, anything. This is called hibernation. We call it as hibernation, the taking rest. The taking rest without, if they don't get the food and they don't adapt to the condition, then they will hide in some safe places. They hide in some safe places. That is called as hibernation. That is called as hibernation. Okay, you understand what is the meaning of hibernation. Next, here they have given the factoscope. A giraffe can consume up to 12 gallons of water. 12 gallons. So what is the gallon? It is a liquid measurement. Measuring the liquid unit. It is one of the unit to measure the water. 1 gallon is nearly equal to, nearly not exactly equal to 3.75 liters. Are nearly equal to 4 liters. That means 12 fours are 48. That means 50 liters, nearly 50 liters it will take. Okay. Consume, that means it will drink at one point of time. That means 50 liters near to 40 to 50 liters it will drink. Its tongue can be up to 18 inches long. How much? 18 inches. That means 1.5 feet. When you come to 1.5 feet, that means in your small scale, that 3 times that length. Small scale has 6 inches, that is 1/2 feet. 1.5 feet means 18 inches means 6 plus 6 plus 6. That much length tongue it has. Okay. Here they are given some figures. Giraffe, sheep and kangaroo. Next, we will move to aquatic animals. Aquatic animals, that is the animals. First we have learnt about the terrestrial or land animals. Now we will move to aquatic animals. Now we will move to aquatic animals. Animals that live in water are called aquatic animals. Whale, shark, snail, octopus, turtles, crabs and fish are some of the aquatic animals. Most of their species live in water and some of them live on land too. They have paired and unpaired fins which help them swim. They have either webbed limbs, duck, or limbs that are modified to paddles, that is in turtle, for swimming. Their body shape is streamlined, that is fish, snake and whales, and their bones are light and spongy. Fish and crabs have gills that help them breathe in water. Shark possesses multiple gill openings. The neck is reduced and external ears are not present. Here how these animals that have adapted for water. Okay. Animals that live in water are called aquatic animals. The animals which live in water. First we have studied the terrestrial means on land. Next we'll come into aquatic animals, that is the animals living in water. Okay. For example, whale, shark, snail, octopus, turtle, crabs and fish. These are the animals which live in the water. Example, whale, shark, frogs, octopus, turtles, crabs, fish. These are the examples for the aquatic animals. Just examples. So many animals are there. We have given the just examples. How they have adapted? Most of their species live in water and some of them live on the land too. That means here some animals are there which live in the water as well as in the earth, as well as on the earth also. The first we will study about the aquatic animals which are living in the water. They have paired or unpaired fins which help them to swim. Paired means one pair, two pair like that, or even numbers or odd numbers. Odd numbers Fins are, even our fins are present in them. For what purpose? Which they help in the swimming. Which help in the swimming. They have either webbed limbs like duck or limbs that are modified to paddles like in turtle for swimming. That means they have webbed. That means the finger to finger, they have a skin-like structure like this. Okay, this is called as webbed feet. This is called as webbed feet here. A skin-like structure is there. When you observe a duck, when you observe the legs of the duck, you will see these webbed feet. This webbed feet. And in the turtle, it is modified into paddles-like structure. That means the paddles, strong paddles-like structure for the swimming purpose. For the swimming purpose, if this is not there, the water will not push easily. By this skin, they will push the water easily at the time of swimming. Here, it acts like the boat one, what we call it, for the boat purpose, we are doing like this, no? Same way, it will act. Okay, the paddle. Their body shape is streamlined. That means like a boat structure. Streamlined means like a boat structure. For example, fish, snake and whales. What is the fish? How does the fish? This is like the streamline. That means easily it will move. Easily it will move. Fish, snakes and whales, and their bones are very light. The weight of the body is very less because their bones are very light and spongy. The body is like a spongy. And for the breathing purpose, fish and crabs have gills that help them to breathe in water. You know very well what are the gills? Gills are the respiratory organs of fish and other aquatic animals. Shark possesses multiple gill openings because shark is a heavy body. It requires more oxygen, so it has multiples of gills openings. That means so many gills are present. The neck is reduced and external ears are not present. That means the neck is reduced due to heavy body and the external ears are not present in the shark. Okay, you understand about the aquatic animals. That is, aquatic animals means the animals which are living in the water are called as aquatic animals. Okay, examples are whale, shark, octopus, okay, turtle, snails, fish. These are all the examples how their body is modified. They have webbed feet. They have webbed feet or paddles, paddles-like structure for their swimming purpose. And they have fins, F-I-N-S. They have fins to swim easily. Fins which help them to swim. Once again, their body is very light. That means the bones are very light and spongy-like structure. So it will float easily in the water. Next, they have gills for respiration purpose. They have gills for the respiration purpose. In whales or shark, they have more gills, gill openings because it needs more oxygen. The neck is reduced and external ears are not present. Next, we'll go for amphibians. Animals that can live on both on land and in water are called amphibians. What are the word? That is the word amphibians. That means the animals which live both in water as well as on land. In water as well as on land are called as amphibians. They are cold-blooded animals. We call them as cold-blooded animals. I will read the para. Animals that can be, that can live both on land and in water are called amphibians. They are cold-blooded animals. This means they do not have a constant body temperature. They adjust themselves with the temperature of their environment. Their moist and scaleless skin help them absorb water and oxygen. However, they also have lungs which help them to breathe on land. Frogs, toads and alligators are amphibians that become inactive when the conditions are unfavorable for their survival. The period of inactivity is called estivation when it occurs during hot and dry weather, and is called hibernation when it occurs during the cold weather. Okay, amphibians, that means the animals which live in water as well as on the land are called as amphibians. Okay, man is not amphibian because man cannot live in the water. Man live only on the earth, so man is a terrestrial animal. Terrestrial animal who lives on the earth. Okay, some animals live in the water as well as in water as well as on the land. So they are called as amphibians. They are cold-blooded animals. The amphibians are cold-blooded. That means they are adjust to the temperature. They don't have constant body temperature. They adjust themselves with the temperature of their environment. If it is a cold, they will adjust to the cold. If it is hot, they adjust to the hot conditions. That means their body temperature varies from cold to hot. But when a man becomes very cold, he will die. If it is hot, he will die. So in the middle, that means in some regular temperature, he has to live. Okay, if the temperature more, he will die. If the temperature is less also, he will die. But these amphibians adjust to the cold as well as to the hot both. Their moist and scaleless skin help them absorb water and oxygen. That means they're scaleless, they don't have the scales. Okay, it absorbs oxygen as well as when it is in the water. It breathes through their skin. However, they also have lungs which help them to breathe on land. They also have the lungs. Through the lungs, it will breathe when it is on the land. They will breathe through the skins when they are in the water. Okay, frogs, toads and alligators are amphibians that become inactive when the conditions are unfavorable for their survival. Some animals in the amphibians, some animals, they inactive if they get the weather bad weather conditions. Bad weather conditions, they become inactive. That means they hide somewhere. They hide somewhere to protect themselves. Okay. The period of inactivity is called, estivation. Here two types, that is estivation and another one is hibernation. Estivation and hibernation. What is the meaning of estivation? The period of inactivity when it occurs during the hot and dry weather. This estivation is called hot, occurs in hot and dry weather. That means if they do not adjust for the hot and dry weather, then they will hide somewhere. That is called as estivation. If they hide due to the hot and dry weather conditions, it is called as estivation. That means not hiding, they will taking rest because they won't adjust to the that climate. If they come, then what they will do? They will destroy or they will die. So what they will do? They will hide some places. That is called as estivation due to the hot and dry weather. If due to the cold weather they hide, that is called as hibernation. For the cold weather, if they hide themselves, it is called as hibernation. Okay, once again I will explain. If the animals hide themselves or take rest for the reason of hot and dry weather, it is called as estivation. For the purpose of cold weather, to hide or take rest, it is called as hibernation. I hope you understand this. Okay, once again I will read the amphibians. Animals that can live both on land and in water are called amphibians. They are cold-blooded animals. This means they don't have a constant body temperature. They adjust themselves with the temperature of their environment. Their moist and scaleless skin help them absorb water and oxygen. However, they also have lungs which help them to breathe on land. Frogs, toads, and alligators are amphibians that become inactive when the conditions are unfavorable for their survival. The period of inactivity is called estivation when it occurs during hot and dry weather, and is called hibernation when it occurs during the cold weather. Okay, this about the adaptation. So we will stop here. In the next class we will continue. Okay, adaptation in animals, that is the animals which live on the earth. It is called as terrestrial animals. That means animals live on the earth in air, water, on the land, and on the trees. Okay, these are the four habitats. Four habitats, that is the on land, in water, in air, as well as on trees. Okay, terrestrial animals are called, the animals which live on land are called as terrestrial animals. In the terrestrial animals, they are divided into desert animals, polar animals, and as well as grassland animals. I explained, in desert, it is very much hot. In polar, opposite, that means very much cold. In the grassland, mild climate, that means not hot, not cold. Okay, and how they have adjusted, that camel, giraffe, and how they have adjusted for the living conditions, and the polar, in polar region, for the that polar bear, penguin, how they have adjusted, and the fur, the fat under the skin, how it protects. So everything we learned on the grassland animals, how the long tongue helps the animals, that means the giraffe, to spot the predators, as well as to get the leaves from the top of the tree. Okay, now we have learned about the aquatic animals also, which have gills to breathe. And the next we have studied about the amphibians, which are living on the land as well as inside the water both. Okay, this is about this lesson. Okay, I hope you understand. Thank you very much.